So when people started to see this kind of attitude, this is Imam al-Hasan, this is Muawiyah, then the message started to become clear. Muawiyah realized this is too dangerous. So then he plotted with Ju'dah, the wife of the Imam, told her, you poison al-Hasan, salamullahi alayh, and I will give you X amount of money, and I will make you the bride of my son Yazid. So this lady, unfortunately, then puts the poison in the milk and gives it to al-Imam al-Hasan al-Mujtaba, salamullahi alayh. After she commits her crime, Muawiyah gives her the money. She says, what about marrying Yazid? He said, if you killed al-Hasan ibn Ali, how can I trust you with Yazid? SubhanAllah. So he did not give her. He said, take the money and go. Khalas. After having the poison, I told you brothers once, I was watching a video one day. This person had a glass with fresh blood. He was stirring the blood. Another person was carrying a snake. You know, some people know how to carry a live snake. You know, he was carrying it in a particular way. And then he presses the head of the snake in a certain fashion where one drop of venom falls into the blood, into this glass. Within seconds, literally, it clots and the whole blood becomes slurry. You know, you can't move the spoon anymore. You can't, within seconds. You know. When I looked at that, I said, SubhanAllah. What did our Imams alayhim as-salam experience when those enemies of Allah gave them poison? What did it do to their inside, to inside their body? And that's why we hear, after being fed the poison, the Imam salamullah alayhi would cough blood. This blood gets clotted, wal'ayadu billah, inside his body. And he starts coughing it. It comes out clotted blood. It looks like liver. That's why some people say the liver of the Imam was coming out. It's these clotted pieces of blood. وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. And the Imam is coughing them. Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam grew with al-Imam al-Hassan. Grew up with him. This is his brother. 47 years since the birth of Imam al-Hussein, this is his brother. So when he sees his brother, Imam al-Hasan, Sayyid Shabab Ahlul Jannah, the man whom Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi used to carry him on his back, and he would walk, he would crawl with him. The Prophet crawls and keeps Hassan and Hussein on his back. Abu Bakr saw, he tells Imam al-Hasan and Imam al-Hussein, what a great ride you have. Your ride is Rasulullah. The Prophet responds to Abu Bakr. He says, what a great riders they are. Great riders. These are Sayyidi Shababi Ahlil Jannah on my back. The leaders of the men of Jannah are on my back. The Sayyid Shababi Ahlil Jannah. Now, what state is he in tonight? He's coughing blood. Imam al-Hussein brings him a plate and he starts coughing into the plate, the blood into the plate. He's in pain. The pain is quite overwhelming. And Imam al-Hussein is crying. Imam al-Hasan alayhi salam starts to comfort the Imam in that difficult state he is. But he loves his brother Abi Abdullah. He doesn't want to see the tears in the eyes of Imam al-Hussein. He says, Ya Aba Abdullah, don't cry. He says, Akhi Aba Muhammad. Imam al-Hussein answers, Akhi Aba Muhammad, it is difficult for your brother to see you in such a state. You are coughing blood. I lived my whole life with you. It is difficult for your brother to see you leaving. He says, Akhi, Ya Aba Abdullah, at least now I am surrounded by you, by Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas, by Bani Hashim. When I'm gonna die, you are going to give me ghusl, kafan. You're going to take me and bury me. But who will be there for you on the day of Ashura, ya Abu Abdullah? لا يوم كيومك يا حسين. There is no day like your day, ya Abu Abdullah. Imam Salamullah عليه المجتبى الحسن, despite his pain, his difficulty, yet look at his rahmah. Even with his brother Imam al-Husayn, Imam al-Ma'soom, look at him. He's trying to comfort him, to ease his difficulty, ease his pain. Then they hear a knock on the door. Imam al-Hasan tells Imam al-Husayn, Ya Aba Abdullah, pick up this plate and hide it, cover it, move it away, remove it. He says, why Aba Muhammad? How come? He says, because Zainab is knocking at the door. I don't want her to enter the house and see my blood on the plate. I am concerned about her. I'm worried about her. I say, Ya Mawlaya, I wish you were there on the day of Ashura. What did Zainab see on the day of Ashura? Imam al-Husayn covered in his blood, covered in arrows and spears. She saw the liver of Abi Abdullah on an arrow that had three heads. She saw the head of Abi Abdullah on the spear. She saw the chest of Abi Abdullah under the horses of Bani Umayyah. She enters the house and she sees her brother in the state, in pain, in difficulty. She cries, Aywa Hasanaya, Aywa Akha, Aywa Masmumaya. Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam comforts her. Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas is next to her. Ah, Ya Abu Abdullah, Ya Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas, where were you on the day of Ashura when she stood on that hill of Zainabiyya, tell Zainabiyya crying, Aywa Muhammada, Aywa Aliya, Aywa Fatimata, أيوة حسنا أيوة حسينا يا جداه يا رسول الله This is your Hussein in Karbala. His body is under the horses of Bani Umayyah. His head is on the spears of Bani Umayyah. While she's in that state, she finds the family of Al-Hur ibn Yazid al-Riyahi coming. They say, Ya Umar ibn Sa'ad, we will not allow you to hurt the body of our man, Hur. We want to take him. We want to bury him. He says, okay, fine, take him. So they carry the body of Hur and they bury him. Zainab alayha salam at that point turns to Najaf. She says, Aba ya Amir al-Mu'mineen. Here is the family of Hur. They came, they carried him. Where is the family of this gharib in Karbala? Where is the family of Abi Abdullah? Inna lillah. إليه راجعون وسيعلم الذين ظلموا أي منقلب ينقلبون والعاقبة للمتقين.